Good day, this is Professor Wills, CBMD PhD, today is Saturday, August 24, 2019, at 16:03 and 55 seconds Eastern Standard Time. And this is a continuation of my research on pathophysiology. So let's hop to it here. Direct removal mechanisms. The simplest repair mechanisms involve the direct photoreversal of pyrimidine dimers to their normal homologs, and the removal of O-alkyl groups from the O6-methylguanine and from the phosphodiester backbone as a consequence of the alkylation damage to DNA. Photolysis, photoreversal, the direct reversal of pyrimidine dimers to the monomeric pyrimidines, is the simplest mechanism, and it is chronologically the first mechanism described for the repair of photochemically damaged DNA. It is a unique mechanism characterized by a requirement for visible light as the sole source of energy for breaking two carbon-carbon bonds. The enzyme protein has two associated light-absorbing molecules, chromophores, which can form an active light-dependent enzyme. One of the chromophores is FADH2, and the other is either a pterin or deanthiflavin, able to absorb the effective wavelengths of 365 to 400 nanometers required for photoreactivation. Of pyrimidine dimers, it is suggested that the photoreversals involves energy transfer from the pterin molecule to FADH2 with electron transfer to the pyrimidine dimer, resulting in non-synchronous cleavage of the C5 and C6 cyclobutane bonds. Enzymes that carry out photoreactivation have been identified in both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Alkyl group removal methyl transferases. Bacterial cells pretreated with less than cytotoxic or genotoxic levels of alkylating agents before lethal or mutagenic doses are more resistant. This is an adaptive phenomenon with anti-mutagenic and anti-cytotoxic significance. During this adaptive period, a 39-kDa ADA protein is synthesized that specifically removes a methyl group from a phosphodiester bond, and from an O6-methyl group of guanine, or from O4-methylthiamine. The O6-methyl group of guanine is not liberated as free O6-methylguanine during this process, but it is transferred directly from the alkylated DNA to this protein. The ADA protein methyl transferase and unmodified guanine are simultaneously generated. These alkyl groups specifically methylate cysteine 69 and cysteine 321 respectively in the protein. The methyl transferase is used stoichiometrically and the process does not turn over and is permanently inactivated in the process. Nascent enzyme, however, is generated because the mono or dimethylated transferase activates transcription of its own regulon, which includes, in addition to the ADA gene, the ALK-B gene of unidentified activity and the ALK-A gene, which sponsors a DNA glycosylates. The latter enzyme acts on 3-methyladenine, 3-methylguanine, O2-methylcytosine, and O2-methylthymine. The methylated ADA protein can specifically bind to the operator of the ADA gene, acting as a positive regulator. Downregulation may be controlled by protease acting at two hinge sites in the ADA protein. Basic scission repair. Basic scission repair by glycosylases and apyrimidimic or apuronic endonucleases. Bases modified by deamination can be repaired by a group of enzymes called DNA glycosylases, which specifically hydrolyze the N-glycosyl bond of that base and the deoxyribose, the DNA backbone generating an apyrimidic or apuronic site, AP site. These are small, highly specific enzymes that require no cofactor for function. They are the most highly conserved proteins attesting to the evolutionary unity both structurally and mechanistically from bacteria to man. As a consequence of DNA glycosylase action, the AP sites generated in the DNA are acted on by a phosphodiesterase. Specific for sites that can nick the DNA, phi transpose and divided by or 3 transpose to such damaged site. If there is a sequential action of a phi transpose acting and a 3 transpose acting AP endonuclease, the AP site is excised, generating a gap in the DNA strand. Glycosylase-associated AP endonuclease. An enzyme from bacteria and phage-infected bacteria encoded in the latter case of a single gene DIN hydrolyzes the N-glycosyl bond of the phi-transposed thiamine moiety of pyrimidine dimer followed by hydrolysis of the phosphodiester bond between the two thiamine residues of the dimer. This enzyme, referred to as the pyrimidine dimer DNA glycosylase, is found in Micrococcus luteus and phage T4 infected E. coli. This small uncomplicated enzyme does not require cofactors and is presumed to act by a series of linked B elimination reactions. An enzyme behaving in a similar glycosylase endonuclease fashion but acting on a radiolysis product of thiamine is thiamine glycol, which has been isolated from E. coli and is referred to as endonuclease. 3. Nucleotide excision repair. The ideal repair system is one that is somewhat indiscriminate and which can respond to virtually any kind of damage. Such a repair system has been characterized in E. coli in which it consists of at least 6 gene products of the UVR system. This ensemble of proteins consists of UVRA, protein that binds as a dimer to DNA in the presence of ATP, followed by the UVRB protein, which cannot bind DNA by itself. Translocation of the UVRA sub-2B complex from initial undamaged DNA sites to damaged sites is driven by a cryptic ATPase associated with UVRB, which is activated by the formation of UVRA sub-2B undamaged DNA complex. This complex is now poised for endonucleotic activity catalyzed by the interaction of the UVRA sub-2B damaged DNA complex with UVRC to generate two nicks in the DNA 7 nucleotides, 5 transposed to the damaged site, and the 3 or 4 nucleotides, 3 transposed to the same site. These sites of breakage are invariant regardless of the nature of the damage. In the presence of the UVRD helicase 3, DNA polymerase I, and substrate deoxynucleoside triphosphates, the damaged fragment is released, and this is accompanied by the turnover of the UVRA and UVRB and UVRC proteins. The continuity of the DNA helix is maintained based on the sequence of the opposite strand. The final integrity of the interpreted strands is restored by the action of DNA polymerase I, which copies the other strand, and by the polynucleotide ligase, which seals the gap. The levels of UVR proteins are regulated by E. coli by an SOS regulon monitoring many genes, including UVRA, UVRB, possibly UVRC, and UVRD, as part of the excision repair system. It also includes the regulators of the SOS system, UVRD, RecA protein, cell division gene, SULA, and SULB, recombination genes, RecA, RecN, RecQ, UVRD, RUV, mutagenic bypass mechanisms, UMUDC, RecA, damage inducible genes, and the lysogenic phage lambda. The LexA protein negatively regulates these genes as a repressor by binding to unique operator region. When the DNA is damaged, e.g. by UV light, a signal in the form of a DNA repair intermediate induces the synthesis of the RecA protein. When induced, the RecA protein acts as a protease, assisting the LexA protein to degrade itself, activating its own synthesis, and that of the RecA protein as well as approximately 20 other genes. These genes permit the survival of the cell in the face of life-threatening environmental changes. Upon repair of the damaged DNA, the level of the signal subsides, reducing the level of RecA, and thus stabilizing the integrity of the intact LexA protein, and its repressive properties are null. The other genes, then the cell returns to its normal state. Transcription-coupled nucleotide excision repair. It appears that the structural and biological specificity associated with transcriptional process limited to DNA repair to those damaged regions of the chromosome undergoing transcription, and that damage in those quiescent regions is persistent. Within expressed genes, the repair process is selective for the transcribed DNA strand for damage, such as pyrimidine dimers, and this coupling to transcription has been shown in E. coli. As a consequence, DNA repair occurs preferentially in active transcribed genes. Preferential repair occurs in the transcribed strand and actively expressed gene. Nucleotide excision repair, NER, differs in the two separate DNA strands of the lactose operon of UV irradiated E. coli. The level of repair examined in the uninduced condition is about 50% after 20 min in both strands. The consequence of 436-fold induction of B. galactosidase, most of the dimers, 70%, are removed from the transcribed strand of the induced operon within 5 min, whereas the extent of repair in non-transcribed strands is similar to that of the uninduced condition. This selective removal of pyrimidine dimers from the transcribed strand of the gene is abolished in the absence of significant levels of transcription. The RNAP, when binding to its promoter site, generates a defined distortion 3 transposed downstream to the RNAP binding site, which provides a landing site for the UVRA sub-2B complex. Strand specificity is dictated by the 5 transpose, 3 transpose directionality of the UVRA sub-2B helicase, which can translocate only on the non-transcribed strand, because RNAP interferes with the directionality of the lower strand. Nicking occurs only on the strand opposite to the strand which the UVRA sub-2B endonuclease binds, hence it is the transcribed strand which is initially repaired in this model. Good day, this is Professor Will, CBMD PhD. Today, Saturday, August 24, 2019. It is 18:09 and 30 seconds Eastern Standard Time. And this concludes my reading on pathophysiology, DNA repair. Hope you enjoy listening. Have a great day.